received this photo in my late 20s, early 30s from my sister, not long after her mother's death. Now, as far as my conscious mind view, I had never been on a farm, and yet there I was. I'm having trouble figuring out whether she's 4 or 5 years old. And it matters to me in my timeline, because I'm missing
so while
years.
I didn't believe that I had ever been on a farm, some part of me knew that wasn't the truth. And maybe truth isn't the right word. Maybe reality. What was the reality? I think that some part of me began to acknowledge that this farm and the experience of it had been inserting itself into my dreams for a good part of my life. But when I'd asked my mom about these strange and repeated dreams,
she just brushed me off and ignored me. She said I had an overactive imagination. Hey, so there were different times in my life that curious things happened. Like here, I would be flying to Toronto. I was attending the National Ballet School. Here I am. I was one of about 12 little ballet bunheads. And were there other people in the photo? I don't know.
I didn't dwell on that photo. I may have tried to ask, but I think that I had already learned that some subjects with my mom were to be avoided.
But why would you cut out someone who was older? And I can't remember exactly what my mom said about it, but of course she ignored it. And it was cut so crudely, it was
Veronique.
Like it was cut with nail scissors. And it was a nice photo, and who could have been?
Sometimes I'd wake up gasping. I remember walking into a room, a living room, and I looked to my right and there were two people. One was a man and the other a boy. I think he was older than me. It felt like he was taller. And the man was speaking to me, but at the same time, I could hear a commotion from the other room. And I remember feeling conflicted. And I looked over at them again, and that boy seemed like he had a smirk on his face. I remember his dark hair, and he had this red coat. I really loved that red coat. And the man was speaking to me, but I could hear this crying in the other room, and the man finally said, "Go, go," and I ran into the other room, and I was terrified. I didn't know what I'd find. And it was my mom. And she was really crying. I was so afraid. She was pleading, "Veronique, help me." She was crying so hard.
She was crying so hard. I had never seen my mom cry so hard. I'll never forget her face. It was red, and the tears and the snot. It was like this white.
I remember sneaking into my mother's closet. I don't even know why. I was a curious kid. Maybe I was going to get to them, but I knew that I wanted to look at them. When I finally did take them down, I opened them up and saw a lot of very curious pictures. They were pictures of my mom with children, but children I didn't know. And my mom was holding their hands. And at that point, I knew I had been living in a foster home on a farm. And I noticed as I was scrolling through my Google research that there was a class action suit against a foster home around the time I was there. There were about 30 children, now adults, suing the home for abuse. I'm pretty sure I was one of those children.
There were people on either side of her. It's like they were dragging her away and something was dropping on the floor. Gosh, she was screaming and they took her away. That's when I was taken away. And I remember looking down at my feet and wishing they could touch the floor of the car.
The eyes almost look like they're looking out beyond where the photographer is, so as if something has sort of caught the attention. And yeah, there's long shadows, which means it's a little bit later in the day. Maybe after the chores have been completed.
I can't tell if she's happy or sad.
I remember a farm. And there were other kids there. And there were these kids standing there.
The cows seemed quite interested in lots of long shadows.
And that's when I decided to run away. I ran at that very moment out the door.